friends. I'm Mrs. Doubts. I'm so excited to share some information with you and guide you through completing a few fun projects at home with your family. Now, in order to complete these first few projects, you'll need to think like a scientist. How do you think like a scientist? Well, scientists use a combination of the inquiry process and the engineering design process. Those are just two fancy ways of saying how scientists do science. Now, the first way we'll talk about is the inquiry process. Inquire just means that you're curious about something and you ask a question to learn more about it. Next, you make an educated guess or a hypothesis as to what you think the answer might be. Now comes the fun part, the hands-on part, where you actually do an experiment to test your hypothesis and see if you're right. That's called drawing a conclusion, seeing if you're right. The final step is to share the results of your experiment so other people can learn from them too. Another way to think like a scientist is by using the engineering design process. It's just another way of being curious, asking questions, and it starts just the same as the inquiry process. You ask a question that you want to know more about. Then you make a plan and you design a model that's going to help you solve your problem. Now, when you test your model, it might not go as planned. However, that's okay. You keep changing, modifying your model until you get it to work just like you want it to. It might take a couple tries, but that's okay. You're a scientist. That's what scientists do. I'm pretty confident that you're curious kids, so let's go ahead and get started. The first project you'll complete is all about friction. Friction? What's that? Well, let's think for a minute. Have you ever slid across a slippery surface? Maybe a patch of ice? Or maybe you've had your socks on and you slid across a wooden floor. Did you ever try to do the same thing with your shoes on in the grass or slide across carpet? Which of those surfaces was easier to slide across? Different surfaces can affect how an object moves, and that's friction, a force that slows an object as it moves. Now, you've heard me use the word surface, and when I say surface, I just mean the outside covering of something. Let's use this ball as an example. The outside layer is the ball's surface. For your project, you'll be designing and building a ramp that's covered with different surfaces. Your job will be to test how an object moves across those surfaces and how friction affects that. Now, later on, I'll show you how to set up your experiment so that you can investigate or find stuff out about how friction affects the movement of objects. The second project you'll be completing is all about force and motion. Now, simply put, force is just the push or pull that makes an object move or sets it into motion. Now, when I think about force and motion, I think about when I was your age and my mom used to push me on the swings and I'd always yell, "Higher, higher," and she'd push harder on the swing and I'd go in the air. That's force and motion. The force is my mom pushing me on the swing and the motion is me going higher and higher in the air. Now, for your force and motion project, you're going to create a space rover that's going to travel across the surface of another planet. Now, I've never traveled to another planet, but that's okay. I can use my imagination, I can use pictures that I've seen of different planets, and that will help me as I'm designing and building my rover. Now, when you test your rover, you'll use force. You'll push your rover to set it into motion. That way, you can test the amount of friction that the surfaces cause as your rover travels across them. You'll be asked to do some very important things as you're working on your projects, just like I talked about earlier. You'll be asked to observe and notice what's happening around you, You'll ask questions as to why things happened the way that they did, and then you'll make a plan to solve a problem and predict how you think your plan will work. And finally, you'll share your discoveries. Sometimes you'll write about them, sometimes you'll draw about them, and sometimes you'll discuss them with your family. So stay curious, ask questions, and have fun. That's what being a scientist is all about, and that's how you learn.
To download the free lesson plans to be used with this program, visit us online at wqed.org/SOS. To request a hard copy of the lesson plans, please contact your local school district. Funding for this program is provided by the Pennsylvania Department of Education for Learning at Home.